Join me for the call to worship. Give thanks to the Lord, for God is good. God's steadfast love endures forever. We have seen God's wondrous works all around us. So we come to praise God's holy name. Open wide your hearts in this time of worship. We lift our hearts to God with thanks and praise. Amen. Shall we pray? Holy and gracious God, source of life and love, we gather in your presence to wonder at the beauty and complexity of all you have made, acknowledging how small and insignificant we are, each on our own. Yet, Lord, you love us with a promise that gives us significance and restores our purpose in the midst of the creation you love. When we are overcome by forces around us, you speak words of peace. When trouble or sorrow sets in, you give us the strength we need to persevere in our witness to your love. Mighty and merciful God, source of hope and wholeness, we confess that we fail you far too often. You call us to serve in the footsteps of Jesus, but we look to our own interests first. You call us to love our neighbors, but we are so good at finding fault in others and withholding our love. Forgive us, Lord. Amen.
Good morning, St. Andrew's family, and to anyone else joining us this morning, all are welcome, and we're happy you're here. On behalf of Senior Leader Ed, Fellow Music Leader Matthew, Video Editor Doug, and myself, Steve, we welcome you to today's installment of our online services from St. Andrew's Church in Owen Sound. We, of course, want to thank everyone that helped to create the content for today, including both the choir and the praise team, who we heard from already, and the call to worship and opening prayer that Ed shared with us. Ed will be bringing our next message in his By Request series in a few minutes. I hope you enjoyed also the organ prelude off the top. Matthew had asked me to record the choir accompaniment this week, so I figured while I was there on the church's organ, I might as well record a little something extra to include today. And of course, thanks to Doug for the beautiful video imagery he and his drone continue to provide. Coming up are two regular contributors to our live stream services. The first being Penny, who is a member of our creative communications team, has put together our scripture video for today. And then on to Sharon, who along with her friend Andy, brings us a visit every week for all of our kids of all ages. After that, we'll be into Ed's message and then back with some more music on the other side. Here's Penny.
The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to Aaron and his sons, saying, 'Thus you shall bless the Israelites. You shall say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.' So they shall put my name on the Israelites, and I will bless them." But now, apart from the law, the righteousness of God has been disclosed and is attested by the law and the prophets. The righteousness of God through faith in Jesus Christ for all who believe. For there is no distinction, since all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. They are now justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Jesus Christ, whom God put forward as a sacrifice of atonement by his blood, effective through faith. He did this to show his righteousness, because in his divine forbearance he had passed over the sins previously committed. It was to prove at the present time that he himself is righteous, and he justifies the one who has faith in Jesus.
Thank you. Andy, you are a raccoon, and Sid, you are a turtle. And you are good friends. Even if we look a little different, we can still care for each other. Knowing and believing in Jesus, our God loves us so very much, just the way we are. Say goodbye.
Welcome, everyone, to the second sermon in our summer series on the topic suggested by St. Andrew's congregants. This week's sermon title is Christianity as Compared with Islam. Shall we come to our Lord in prayer? Dear God, may the words of my mouth, the meditation of all our hearts together, be pleasing and acceptable to you, O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Dear congregation, a couple of years ago, while serving in London, a mechanic I used for oil changes and tire changes for our vehicle was a dad of a refugee Muslim family whom the Presbytery of London sponsored from the Presbyterian Church in Canada. He, his wife, and five children have come to visit our congregation and during the service took a moment to give thanks to the church for the congregation's generous support in sponsoring them. He had started his own business in London, and I wanted to support him. He rented a garage with an office in an industrial complex and was all set up to do vehicle repairs. The first time I went there to change my tires from winter tires to summer tires, he absolutely insisted that when I was ready to pay, that it was, quote, no charge. I tried hard, but he would have nothing of it. I wanted to pay him. So I said, Thank you so much. He was so thankful for what all the churches did for his family, and this was a token of his appreciation. The next time I went, he tried it again, saying no charge, so I put my foot down and paid him. The interesting part was when the time came in the afternoon for him to do his prayers, and I was waiting around in the office for the car to be done, he stopped work, took out his prayer mat, and prayed. Everything stopped for prayer. Not long, but long enough to ensure that he had prayed. I was impressed with his dedication to his faith. Individuals who practice faith different from our own have increasingly become our neighbors. People of many faiths comprise the population of Canada. As a church, God calls us to a perspective not only to tolerate the other, but to see another as an important member of a strong society, though we come from different cultures and beliefs. We can learn from one another. As all people are created in the image of God, we are to see others as holy and dearly loved by God. Islam is the second largest religion in the world, behind the largest, which is Christianity. Bev Wilkins, St. Andrew's Parish nurse, has also provided some facts about Islam in one of the congregational emails not too long ago. Muslims, Christians, and Jews worship the same and only God we read about in the Old Testament, and Abraham is a spiritual ancestor common to all three religions. Islam is based on the teaching of the Prophet Muhammad, where his writings are found in the Quran. Muslims believe that Muhammad was the last of the great prophets sent by Allah, sent by God. Here are some differences with Islam as compared to Christianity. Muslims recite their confession of faith daily. It goes like this, quote, "There is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his prophet." Jesus is one of their prophets, but they do not believe in Jesus as their savior, or that Jesus is God, or that Jesus rose from the dead. When they pray, they face in the direction of the city of Mecca, or what is called the Qibla. They do not worship the city of Mecca, no, but they are united as a people of faith praying together, united in that direction. Mecca is the holiest of Muslim cities. The Islam faith began in the 7th century Common Era, or CE. Muhammad, who is the founder of Islam, was born in the city of Mecca, and it is toward this religious center of Mecca that Muslims turn toward 5 times daily in prayer. All devout Muslims who are able attempt a Hajj or a pilgrimage to Mecca at least once in their lifetime. Because Mecca is considered sacred, only Muslims are allowed to enter the city. Islam, like Christianity and other religions, is a religion of peace and of helping our neighbors as Allah would desire. Allah is a term used for God, which Muslims and also Arabic-speaking Christians and some Jews use when referring to God. It's important to remember that we are called by God to work individually and collectively to stop crimes against those from other faiths, of ethnic minorities, and crimes against others. All people are created in the image of God and loved by God. Jesus said, quote, "A new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you." We are called to love our neighbors as ourselves. The mayor of London, Ed Holder, along with the mayor of Quebec City, Régis Labama, wrote a joint letter to the Prime Minister in support of an emergency national action summit on Islamophobia in the wake of the attack. The attack in London, Ontario, was the worst against Canadian Muslims since 6 people were killed in a Quebec City mosque in 2017. The letter of Mayor Ed Holder and Quebec City Mayor Régis Labama goes on to offer support for municipalities in helping to, quote, eradicate the scourge of Islamophobia across the country. In the letter, both Holder and Labama articulated the need to combat all forms of hatred, including anti-Semitism. A separate summit addressing the rise in anti-Semitism in recent months is also in the works. In a discussion I had last week with the local imam, Hafiz Motorwala, from the Owen Sound Muslim Association, among other things which Islam and Christianity have in common, we discussed how humility is key to both our faiths. We agreed that pride wounds relationships, but humility builds bridges. We also agreed how sincere gratefulness of gifts in life from Allah, gifts from God, builds satisfaction in one's life and guards against greed of always wanting more. In gratitude, one is thankful that God provides, and one does not need to worry about the future. A fundamental difference between Christianity and Islam is that Christians believe that Jesus is the incarnated Son of God. Jesus is divine and without sin. Islam, however, teaches that Jesus was one of the most important prophets of God, but Jesus is not the Son of God. Jesus is not divine, nor is he part of the Trinity. In my conversation with the imam, he mentioned that in Islam theology, quote, good deeds can mitigate minor sins by canceling them out or erasing them. Good deeds in one's life is very important in building one's, quote, standing in the eyes of Allah. A person who committed major sins can achieve forgiveness from Allah if he or she sincerely asks for forgiveness. Works of good deeds do enable rewards for salvation to eternal life. Muslims are dependent on Allah's mercy, as Allah decides who can enter heaven. However, the greater the performance of good works a person does in their life improves their potential rewards for eternal life. In terms of God's grace in the Christian faith, which is very different from the Islam faith, in the Christian faith, one cannot earn their way into heaven with good works. Our salvation is totally dependent on God's grace in Jesus Christ. John 3:16 says this, a number of us know this by heart, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life." Eternal life is a gift. All one needs to do is to receive this gift by having faith in Jesus. Good deeds are good for advancing of God's kingdom, but not as a means to earn God's special favor. The good deeds of a Christian springs out
of response of gratitude and joy to share the goodness and love of God with others. Someone raised the objection that receiving the gift of eternal life is not totally grace because you still have to do something to receive the gift. As a response, you can say that receiving the gift does not imply that you earned it. Receiving is not working to earn the gift. You are only opening the door. So the free gift of life, which Jesus gives today and for eternity, can be enjoyed by you. For example, if someone gives you a gift on your birthday and you receive it, it is your gift. Just because you received it does not mean you deserved or earned it. It is a complete free gift you can enjoy. When one has trust, faith in Christ, the gift of abundant life of God's presence abides with you daily, and the gift of everlasting life is yours even now today as you are alive, and as you look forward with peace and even joy to your heavenly home with Jesus. In our New Testament scripture reading for today from Romans 3, verse 21 to 26, we read about becoming righteous through faith in Christ. In verse 23, we read this, quote, "For there is no distinction." In other words, whether you do more good deeds than another, no one finds more favor from God because of the goodness performed. Why? Since all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. But the scriptures go on to say this, quote, "They are now justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a sacrifice of atonement by his blood, effective through faith," end of quote. The incarnation of God, that is God coming down to earth in human form in Jesus Christ, was done by God in great love and great sacrifice for the people God created. Through the incarnation, we know the nature of God because he came down to earth to be one of us, so we can know him not only as the Almighty Creator, the Creator God in God's creation, but also as the personal God we know in Jesus Christ. Through the incarnation of the Almighty into Jesus Christ, God came so close that we know that he knows us personally and even knows you by name. As Christians, the Bible is the revelation of God through Jesus Christ. The Bible itself reveals God, but always through the lens of who Jesus is, what he has done to save us by his loving grace. Speaking of the gifts of God's grace, let's read from our Old Testament reading from Numbers 6, verse 22 through 26. We read the benediction from God for the people of Israel as they are on their journey. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, quote, "Speak to Aaron and his sons, saying, 'Thus you shall bless the Israelites. You shall say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.'" This benediction is appropriate for worship services because it talks about the blessings of God's grace on all people as they are on a journey of life. And the same goes for us today in Canada as we leave our worship services on Sunday and continue our journey each day in the world. In verse 24, we read about being blessed and kept secure by God. Verse 25 speaks of God's radiant face, which gives us hope and direction on our daily path and into the future. In spite of the danger, you will experience God's loving graciousness. In verse 26, we are comforted by God's countenance or God's support and peace going into the uncertain future or the unknown. This is a scriptural blessing of God's amazing grace we can trust. In our context of our congregation at St. Andrew's Owen Sound, I've heard it said often that our congregation is caring, is loving, supportive, attentive, etc. I was pondering that St. Andrew's congregation is a reflection of God's grace on our journey, as we see in this benediction. We bless one another. We show God's bright face of hope to one another as we are his body, the hands and feet of Christ. We help each other and others with unconditional love, prayer support, and give one another God's peace in spite of the circumstances we are dealing with. The Christian faith is unique from Islam faith and other world faiths in that it is all about God's grace in Jesus Christ. In other words, through Christ, we know that there is nothing we can do to make God love us more, and there is nothing we can do to make God love us less. God's love is steadfast in spite of what we have done or did not do. Last year in London, Ontario, one of my congregants was sharing how she works with some Muslim people in her office, and they are very committed to their faith. She became close friends with a few of them. There were others in her office who claimed to be agnostic and did not think about God or spiritual things much at all. She shared with me that though she is a Christian and her friends are Muslim, she shares more in common with them because of their faith, though different, than those who claim to have no faith. After this conversation, I reflected again on how God calls us to love our neighbors, and it is good for us. We all have in common that we are created in God's image, and to respect others in spite of how they are different. And this expands our world by God's Holy Spirit. Not to be afraid, but to love them as Christ loves us so dearly by his grace. In my conversation with our local imam this week, it became clear that he and his faith community take their faith in Allah very seriously. Their passion and commitment to Allah is inspiring. As followers of Christ, we are to be passionate and committed to Christ. Not so much to work harder and get burned out, no, but to rest in God's grace and live in the confidence of that grace that we are not alone in this world. He gives us joy. Let the Holy Spirit strengthen you and give you the words to share the precious good news of Jesus Christ. As we meet our neighbors of other faiths, remember that we all share that we are children of God, holy and dearly loved, and known personally by our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Shall we pray? Dear God, thank you for calling us to connect with our brothers and sisters of other faiths. Bless us in our connections with others and remind us to share the good news of your grace and love and respect for all. Help us to connect with others in love and not fear. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Bring me near, draw me to your side.
Thanks, Praise Team, for your help with that song. You guys are the best. Thanks, Penny and Sharon, for both those segments we heard right before the message. And of course, Ed, for those thoughts and encouragements in your message today. A reminder of the long list of music and kids content videos from past Sundays that you'll find on our YouTube channel. We have well over 125 music videos and almost 50 kids videos there now. The choir is going to close our time with another beautiful hymn, one that you might know a different set of lyrics to, as was the case with me, but a beautiful one nonetheless. But first, Ed will bring today's benediction to send us off. Have a great week, and we'll see you soon.
Lift up your hearts to God, receive His blessing, and go in peace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the fellowship, the communion, the love of the Holy Spirit be and abide with you always this day, tomorrow, the day after that, and forevermore. Amen.
God of mercy, God of grace, show the brightness of your face. Shine upon us, Savior, shine. Fill your world with light divine, and your saving help extend unto earth's remotest end. Let